A very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to start with our chapter, International Organization. In this chapter, we will discuss the role of international organizations after the collapse of Soviet Union in 1991. And here, one of the major international organization is United Nations, and its logo has been given here. It is having the emblem that has a world map with olive branches around it, and it signifies world peace. Now, the first topic is why international organizations. International organizations here, one, the role of United Nations have been depicted very easily here in these two cartoons. In these two cartoons, the Lebanon was under fire, and Israel in 2006 June month, Israel has attacked Lebanon by saying that they wanted to control the militant group Hezbollah that is backed up by Iran. Iran di support te jehde Hezbollah militant group kafi sakriya hai, kafi active hai. In that, Israel attacked Lebanon, and this was known as the crisis of Lebanon 2006. In this attack, many civilians were killed, many public buildings and residential areas that also came under the bombarding of Israel. When United Nations passed a resolution in August, Israeli army withdrew from the region only in the month of October. Means August which UN ne resolution pass kita, te fir us ton kafi mahiniyan de baad, kareeb 2-3 mahiniyan baad hi Israel ne apni army nu wapas bheja. It means that ineffectiveness of United Nations has been shown. Under this, we can have two dialogues, two comments made by two insiders only. One was the UN Second Secretary General Dag Hammarskjöld. He said that United Nations was not created to take humanity to heaven, but to save it from hell. That the main objective of United Nations is to save united all the world, the whole humanity from stepping into the area of hell. And Shashi Tharoor, he was the former UN Under Secretary General for Communications and Public Information. You must have heard about his speeches and all. And he is saying that talking shop, instead of bombarding to one another, getting indulged in war, it's better to be in jaw and jaw. Jaw and jaw means the world war. Isn't it better to have one place where all the countries in the world can get together, bore each other sometimes with their words, rather than bore holes into each other on the battlefield? As explained by Shashi Tharoor, that it is always better to bore the people of various nations. It's always better to bore holes into each other in the battlefield. Now the question arises that why international organizations are needed. International organizations help in matters of war and peace. They also help countries to cooperate with one another to make better living conditions for all of us. So this is all. With this, sometimes we indulge to deal with their antagonisms, their conflicts, their enmities, their controversies. They are all dealt with the international organizations, for example, United Nations. It tries to find peaceful solutions of all the disputes that arises between the nations of the world. Under this chapter, the first question that comes under one mark, as already I want to tell you that from this chapter, 6 marks and 4 marks question can come. 6 marks and 4 marks question can come. As you all know that the First World War, it was fought from 1914 to 1918. After this war, to stop all the world wars and all the disputes, League of Nations was founded. But this League of Nations, it failed in establishing peace in whole of the world. And in 1939 to 1945, the Second World War was fought. Now the first question is, when was UN formed and where is its headquarters? The answer can be marked here with pencils by all of you. That United Nations was founded as a successor of League of Nations. It was just the League of Nations which was established during First World War to stop the war, but it failed to do so. So in as a successor, United Nations was formed. It was established on 24th October 1945. And the main objective was to avoid war, but it has shown its ineffectiveness in the past few decades. In the today's pandemic era, United States have blamed China of spreading this pandemic, but United Nations has done nothing in this sort. It means it has become ineffective. So we were doing about when it was formed. It was established on 24th October 1945, and India joined it on 30th October 1945. Under this United Nations, it was set up through signing of United Nations chartered by 51 states. 51 nations of the world, they signed United Nations charter, and it tried to achieve what the League of Nations was failing, and League could not between the two world wars. It's now a two mark question, that what is the objective of United Nations? The main objective of United Nations is to prevent international conflict and to facilitate cooperation among the states. Jinne bhi international conflicts nahi, chahe wo Lebanon de naal related hai, Syria de naal related hai, Palestinians de naal related hai, Pakistanis or India's the Kashmir issue hai. So all these conflicts prevent karan de layi, and to facilitate cooperation among the nations of the world, United Nations has been established. And it was established with the hope that it would act to stop conflicts between states escalating into war, and if war broke out, to limit the extent of hostilities. Ki inki koshish rahegi United Nations ki sare ke sare conflicts ko stop kiya jaye, aur kabhi bhi aisi war jaisi condition arise na hone di jaye, aur agar ho bhi jati hai to fir uski jiske outcomes hain war ke wo kam se kam nuksan ho. So before that, I must tell you that there are many organs of United Nations system that we are going to do here, but the principal organ is Security Council and General Assembly. Security Council de vich 15 members hunde ne jinnu assi suraksha parishad kehne aa. We have 5 among them which are permanent members. They have veto power, you know that it is a negative power, ki agar ek member kahega kisi bhi resolution par no kahega to fir sabhi members ko wo resolution pass nahi ho sakta. Koi bhi permanent member, 5 permanent members mein kisi bhi ek member ke paas veto power hoti hai, 3-5 members ke paas veto power hoti hai, it is a negative power. And 10 other members, first of all talk about 5 permanent members because they were in a position of a strong financial and political hold at the time of 1945. When in 1945 United Nations was set up, it was established at that time, these 5 nations, permanent nations, United States, Russia, China, United Kingdom and France, these were at peak. They were holding an economic and political power in their hands. They were quite strong at that time, and that is why they were holding this seat of permanent membership. And 10 other members are there, which are elected by the General Assembly for 2 years term. Every 2 years, these are being changed. Now, next organ of United Nations is your General Assembly. Representatives of all the 193 member states, they are the members. Every state can send their members in the General Assembly. 193 member states, their representatives are the members of General Assembly. This is known as Aam Sabha. They are having the right to cast one vote only, and major decisions they require 2/3 majority. जो मेजर डिसीजंस हैं उनके लिए 2/3 मेजॉरिटी की ज़रूरत होती है, और बाकी सभी के लिए सिंपल मेजॉरिटी आप कह लें. एंड जो जनरल असेंबली के जो डिसीजंस हैं, दे आर नॉट डिसीजंस नॉट बाइंडिंग ऑन यूनाइटेड नेशंस. नाउ दीज आर द टू इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रिंसिपल ऑर्गन्स. इंटरनेशनल कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस, it is having 15 judges elected from 9 years, for a period of 9 years, by absolute majority in both General Assembly and Security Council, and it is based at Hague, which International Court of Justice the headquarter hai. Secretariat main do hi organs karne hunde hai, Security Council te General Assembly, jide bare paper vich puchha ja sakda hai. Other members are Secretariat that international staff servicing the other principal organs. This is headed by Secretary General, and who is appointed by General Assembly. Antonio Guterres, he is the present Secretary General of Secretariat, and this Secretary General is appointed by General Assembly on the recommendation of Security Council for a period of 5-year term, and this term can be renewable. Next is your Economic and Social Council. Member states elected by the General Assembly for overlapping 3 years terms, 54 seats based on geographical representation. Jitne bhi member states hote hain, they are being elected by the General Assembly for a period of 3 years term. 3 years ki term hundi hai members di. 54 seats hoti hai, jo ki geographical representation ke accordingly hi इकोनॉमिक और सोशल काउंसिल में प्राप्त होती है. ट्रस्टीशिप काउंसिल दैट वॉज मेड फॉर द पर्पज अर्लियर एट द टाइम ऑफ इट्स एस्टैब्लिशमेंट टू गेट द फ्रीडम ऑफ दोज नेशंस विच आर अंडर द रूल ऑफ सम कलोनियल और इम्पीरियल पावर, बट आफ्टर द इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ पलाउ इट वॉज सस्पेंडेड ऑन 1 November 1994. Because it was just last UN Trust ki jede members hain unna di last territory Palau hi si, te e jadon independence mil gayi Palau nu te fir trusteeship council nu bhi suspend kar ditta gaya. I want to repeat this thing that General Assembly is having permanent members. All the 92-93 members, they are the part of General Assembly. And if we talk about United Nations Security Council, it is having 5 permanent members. They are Russia, United Kingdom, France, China and United States. These states are selected as permanent members, but 10 members, they are replaced every 2 years. And the present General Secretary is Antonio Guterres, 9th Secretary General, and he took up the charge as Secretary General on 1st January 2017. This is all with today's topics. Next topic we will start with the next day.